Are you pulling your hair out because your app crashes and you don't know why? Well, in this video, we are going to tackle just that with the help of Testflight and Testflight with Crashlytics. Alex here from Rebeloper.com, and I want you to hit that subscribe button because in this video, we are going to dive deep into testing crashes within your app. Crashes. You want to avoid them, but if they occur, you want to know about them. So that is what Testflight is going to show you. First of all, I will just view the app on Testflight. You will receive something like this in the email if you are invited. And let me just go through it. And then, if you recall in the previous videos, I have built an app that is kind of crashing because, yeah, that's what we want to test. I will hit the button and the app will crash. And hopefully we will see that in the crash reports inside Testflight. So let me just select view in Testflight here. Okay, we want to get the Testflight app from the App Store. And then open Testflight and choose redeem and enter this code. So I would just copy this out. I will just simply go to the Testflight app because I have already downloaded it. Tapping on redeem, pasting in there, tapping redeem. It's loading. Okay. Thank you very much. Testflight example Rebeloper. So let's open this up. Okay. And from the developer, Testflight example, what to test? Test my app with Testflight. And if you recall, I have added this into the notes for testers to read. Okay, let's click on next here. Share feedback. You could share the feedback by tapping on these buttons, or you could just tap on here, learn more. So let's start testing. Okay, so let's tap me. I'm tapping, and as we expected, it just crashed. And that is what we should see in the Testflight dashboard. So let's just go over here and check it out. Okay, so while we wait for the crash to appear, and you will see that under Testflight crashes, let me just show you a little bit more of the Testflight app. So if you select the Testflight app, not the one that I have created, I know it's kind of similar here, but do may remind that there is the Rebeloper logo there. So tapping on Testflight, you will see that there is our app. And if we tap on the title or the description or tap on the open button, it will open up the app. Now, if we go and tap on the button, like the icon, we can see some details about the app. And what I really want to show you here is there is a button called Send Beta Feedback. And you could just send some feedback to the developer. It will be sent to their email address that they provided. So you could also add a screenshot here. So let's just create a screenshot of our app right here. There we go. And there we have our screenshot, and let's tap on Send Beta Feedback. Include screenshot. Yes, I will include the screenshot of this one. Okay, there we go. And let's tell us about your experience. And basically, that's it. Here we have our screenshot, as you can see, and tapping on Submit will send them this feedback. Okay, and by the way, you could just also stop testing if you want to and set the notification, preview builds, and so on. Okay, so now that you know how you can send better feedback, all you have to do, well, if you are a developer, is just wait for those crashes to appear under the test flight. Now, this could take a while, of course. I usually get them in a day or two, but yeah, you get those crashes and some analytics with them. Now, that is how you can test your crashes inside the Testflight app. And while you wait for that crash to occur, make sure to check out my next video, because in my next video, I will be talking about Testflight alternatives. That is right, there are some alternatives to Testflight which are better or worse. But in the meantime, while you wait for that, make sure to hit that notification bell and check out these videos as well too. I talk a lot about Swift UI, Swift in general, and as usual, I will see you in the next one.